Good afternoon, everybody. Before beginning my presentation, I would like to say that this idea is part of a work, of a research project called Crocodile 2, which from the Greek part we have the Ministry of Transportation as the main beneficiary organization. And as to...
Excuse me, I'm sorry for the interruption. Just give us...
You can give us a few minutes to fix, the...
So as I was saying, this idea, this paper is part of a work that comes from a European project where the Ministry of Transportation is the main beneficiary, and University of Patras and our University of Applied Sciences are, will deliver a system that in some changes will be used for also for electric vehicle transportation purposes, and we will explain it in a few minutes. So the main objective of this paper is to present this ITS, as it's called, Intelligent Transportation System tool, that will lead to energy savings in freight transport. We want to use it afterwards with some changes for smart charging scheduling of electric vehicles. And finally, all, especially the second part, will lead to optical electricity grid and renewable energy sources operation. A few words about Crocodile in Greece. Its aim is to harmonize data from traffic and from safe and secure track parking areas, SSTPAs, track parking areas, that come from not only from Greece but from many countries. And specifically, it has two main objectives: to establish the national access point and to deliver the system, the ITS system, that will supply dynamic information to drivers and vice versa. So the equipment that we'll need for this system is shown in this slide. It is better to show you the configuration. We see that we use a wide area machine vision camera. Of course, lighting and fencing is used for the track parking area. These are ancillary things. And here we have an ANPR system, automatic number plate recognition system, a QR code that is used for the driver when he comes out of the parking, and the data transmission of the system is shown here. The drivers of the truck or the electric vehicle will see in dynamic information, it means that is there any free parking space for a specific time frame of the day at this parking. He can then with his cell phone try to find or to book a place, a parking place at this place, at this starting parking area, and then when he reaches at the parking area, the ANPR system reads his place, he goes inside, and when he leaves, he has the QR code in his cell phone, He uses to go out. It's not a system that is prototype. It will be set up with existing and commercial, as you see, infrastructure. It will use, however, new and innovative software applications, which will be developed during this project. So, what we want to emphasize in this presentation is that there is an added value of all this system, that it will be used for this project, but it can be used for other projects. For example, the added value of this system is that it can be used for, in the future, for electric vehicles. Electric vehicles in the future will be large for consumers with great effect on the electricity grid. And if we consider that in a few years, in some countries already, in Greece, in the next year, we will have the intraday variation of the feed-in tariff. That means that when you want to charge your electric vehicle, it will be expensive in peak hours. So this IDS system will help smart charging, will facilitate smart charging for efficient allocation of the electric vehicles to the day. How can we do that? We can use the platform that I showed you here, and we can fit this platform with the energy price signals. So the aim is to reserve charging places automatically or the user zone during the valley periods, meaning hours with high renewable resources production or with low feed-in tariff. Finally, I will show you two pilot graphs that come from a pilot system of these authors that you see down there. They simulated this type of smart charging. You see here the electricity grid. The first picture on the left and up shows the electricity grid as it is today, without charging of using electric vehicles. They then try to simulate what is the strain that will be put on the electricity grid if we charge electric vehicles whenever and wherever we want. You see that the red areas are the places of the grid that the network has problems. If we use the dual tariff policy, which like today in Greece, the period will have cheaper electricity than other periods, the night, times the night usage, so we say, we see that again at the low left figure, again the effect is not so big. And if we use the smart charging idea of electric vehicles, then we increase also the vehicles that can be charged, and we can decrease the strain on the power network. So actually, we know from simulations that smart charging is a good idea for the future. We now have also the IPS, which we propose to use for such applications, and we will go on in a future project. There's a future project in our region, in West Macedonia, that's called Green Internet Mobility, that it is approved by an Interreg program that will do exactly this. Two municipalities, one municipality in Greece, two municipalities, Florina and Brespas, are going to install in their premises electric vehicle charging stations, and we're using this IPS application, of course with some changes, not the same exactly, they will try to apply smart charging at these charging stations, and also try to use the electric vehicles that they will buy in a more effective way also for other transportation means, like for school students' transportation and other things. So that's it for me.